Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'll show you how to vibe code a tool that can not only crawl the internet for your favorite type of data, but also present it to you in a really nice fashion. Here's the backstory. Very soon, I'm leaving the beautiful English countryside for the sunny climes of Cyprus, but I know very little about this country, which is why I've headed to Komoot, one of my favorite tools for finding hiking trails around the country. Look at how it categorizes them, tells me how many people hiked, and what the rating is, and whether it's easy, intermediate, or hard. I can also swap the sport type, so I can have road cycling, running as well. This all sounds great, and I could browse around that site for hours, but I'd like to get all of the data into a nice little spreadsheet. So I head off to Google, search for Komoot, and I find Komoot, and look, I also find Komoot API. This is a very good sign, meaning I can vibe code something to grab the data from the API. Let's just go ahead and click into this, and we do not offer a publicly accessible API. Just as I was starting to get excited about vibe coding with Komoot for my data source, I'm stopped in my tracks, but no, there is a solution. Right underneath Komoot API, there is another result here. Let's click it, and it takes me to Apify, where this is an idea to make a Komoot API that crawls the site and finds the best trails. Sounds awesome. I should mention, if you click the link down below, not only will you be able to enter an Apify $1 million challenge to create your own web data crawler, but also by using my link, I'll provide you with my markdown files that I'm using to make the data crawler in this video. Let's get stuck in. Now, remember here, if you want to build something yourself to work on the Apify platform, you don't have to do the Komoot API. You can go to View All Ideas and look at this webpage, which I'll also link down below. It gives you tons of ideas that have never been developed before to grab all kinds of data from the web, and you could go ahead and build one of those yourself. And by the way, next month in December, I'll be one of the judges deciding who wins, so leave me a comment down below if you're going to build. All right, with that said, how can I get all of these data points into a nice little spreadsheet, or even better, a vibe-coded app that helps me find the right trail for me? Well, this is my setup stack, and it's the stack I'll share with you in the link down below. First of all, install the Apify CLI. This runs from the command line and allows your agent to interact with Apify. Once it's installed, using my documentation, you'll type Apify login. It'll ask if you want to log in through the Apify console, which I highly recommend you do. And then when you confirm this, you'll see you've got a success. You're logged in to Apify as, in my case, Creator Magic. Next up, we should install Chrome DevTools, another link here. And in my instance, I'll be using Codex to vibe code. So I just copy this command, paste it into my terminal, hit enter, and it's done. That's it. Step three is to start vibe coding. So I cleared the terminal. You see I can run Codex or Claude code, and everything else is explained in my agents markdown file, how to make an agent, and also these handy markdown files that are from Apify explaining the structure of the crawler we're about to build. I'll now get started by typing Codex dash dash YOLO to get started coding. It really couldn't be easier. Now, I don't need to worry about any of the workings of Apify because that's documented in my markdown files that I'll share with you. All I need to do is head over here to the Apify idea page for the thing that I'm building, copy this, paste the content into Codex. It's probably a good idea to actually give the URL that you want to start at, which is, in my case, komoot.com/discover, and we'll hit enter and let my vibe coding tool do all the rest of the work. So you'll see it's inspecting the repo structure. It's already looking at Chrome DevTools, and look at this, popping open Chrome there to get Komoot loaded up. Now, what is it doing at this stage? It's actually inspecting how the website works and the easiest way to grab the data from that website so that we can systematize it and put it into the tool that we make. Okay, and look at this. It's actually controlling the website without me touching the keyboard. This is the idea of vibe coding an actor for Apify. It's browsing through the website, understanding how everything works so we can get this data and use it ourselves. If we actually look here, it's investigating the API requests. It's done quite a lot with Chrome DevTools. This is the kind of stuff I might have spent hours trawling through the actual developer interface inside Chrome in the past. Now it's all automated by AI, and you can do it too. And believe it or not, it's actually understanding here how this works, and we have 94% of context left. It's literally trying everything. Now you'll see it's running curl commands to get the data of different routes. And when this all finishes, it will go into the My Actors section of my Apify account. You'll see I've got a supermarket crawler, Apple Podcast Explorer, small business searcher, some Zapier tools, and also YouTube tools as well. This is my public page on Apify, and actually I've made a couple of those actors public for you to try yourself. Now, if you want to join the challenge yourself, click Join the Challenge and type in your email. I can't believe my AI agent can actually handle this. And still, 79% context left. So despite a big chunk of data coming in, my AI agent is handling this incredibly well, creating different endpoints for me to use when this is finally in production. And it's only been working for just over 6 minutes so far. The best thing about vibe coding actors for Apify is you don't need to know how these websites work or give you their data. Codex or Claude Code will figure it out for you. And it's also really clever. I see the initial data only has 5 items, but there are 1,000 total, so I need to find out how to page through the data set. This is the kind of cool stuff I just wouldn't be able to do by myself, but Codex does it all for me. And look at this, as a true Garmin watch owner, it's even figuring out how to export GPX files of the root data. Okay, look at this. It seems to have got enough data. Now it's scaffolding the Apify Actor project. Now, I've got to say, the reason I love Komoot is because when you actually click on a trail, it zooms into the exact spot and it gives you this beautiful graphic of where you need to go to complete the trail, other trails that are nearby, and also beautiful images and even some reviews and information from previous hikers. And we can actually see not only has it scaffolded out the Apify Actor, it's now implementing everything like geocoding, route search, detail enrichment, and other optional assets. And it's really making great progress on getting all the data it needs to make this work. Now you'll see it's actually gone ahead and tested this and it's found 12 routes. And we can see these are actually stored as dataset items with full information here on Frankfurt area. And so much data, I won't even know what to do with this. It's got 12 different routes, which is amazing. And now it's preparing the README. So it looks like we're getting towards the end of vibe coding our actor. And bear in mind, all you need to do this kind of task is have patience, because it's taken nearly 20 minutes to do this job and it's now wrapping up. So if you can wait for 20 minutes, you can essentially get a fully fledged Apify Actor built and pushed to your account. And look at that, nearly 20 minutes on the nose. And we've got a wrap up from Codex. Yes, this is ready to test. Now that we've had this wrapped up and we've still got 55% context left, I've said, can you push this to Apify via the CLI, run a bunch of small tests and fix anything that's broken? A very simple second prompt that will get this into my Apify account and also test it a few times and already start fixing things before I notice there's an issue. There we go. We can see that it's running some targeted local tests to confirm it's stable. Then it will push it and it will rerun a test directly on Apify using the command line Apify run. You'll see right now it's searching Berlin, Germany. Now it's preparing to push via the Apify CLI. What this will do is push the actor I just created into my Apify account. And this is powerful because now I can test it out in my Apify account and when it's ready, deploy it, start making money from it, and potentially win a big prize in the Apify Actor Challenge. Okay, you'll see on the first push the build actually failed. This is not a problem as we're using Codex to vibe code. It's just going to make sure to update what needs to be updated and repush to make sure it works. Now you'll see my Apify account, after a bit of back and forth and iterative self-improvement, we have a succeeded build. This means my actor is now ready to use in my account. Let's try it. Let's actually go ahead and test this out by clicking source and input. And for location, we'll go for Paphos, Cyprus. We'll leave Landlong empty. The search radius we'll keep as it is. We'll switch from hiking. Let's go for jogging instead. And then I think we'll leave everything else pretty much as is. We just want to see if this actually works in the first instance. Save and start. Now it's actually running my actor. It will go ahead and grab the data. It's already grabbed 12 routes and we've got an output here with, look at this, 12 routes pulled in from Komoot. And you'll see we have the name of the routes. We also have the popularity of the routes as to how many visitors are actually using those routes. We've also got IDs for the routes, bunch of other information here. Elevation up, elevation down. Now, all of this data is great. It would sit very nicely in a spreadsheet, but now we want to get it into a nice app that can do stuff with that data to make it valuable. So with a couple of prompts, I basically have a fully fledged Apify actor. Now I'm going to add some data. I'm going to keep it named as Komoot API. Under display information, let's upload an image. That looks good. I'll also add in a description here and we'll use the AI suggestions of travel, automation and other. Now, the important thing, if you want to get paid for every usage of your actor, you would set up monetization here. For the challenge, you'll want to select pay per event and continue. You'll then add your markup to the pricing and confirm. That means it can be found in the Apify store and you get paid when anyone uses it. Okay, with this tested and thoroughly working, we can see we have outstanding work. We've put all the info in. Monetization is active. Our sample input and data put schema is active. So now we can click to publish to the store. And boom, we get a little URL down here. I can click it. My actor is now available here on the store, ready to be used. You can put in an input. It tells you the input. But the best news now is it's super easy to vibe code a web app that uses this tool. Over here on the public URL, we just add .md, and look at this. We get a flat markdown file of exactly how our Apify actor works. So I can feed this to something like Claude Code and build something useful. So now I've made an empty directory here with nothing in it. I'll run Claude Code. The prompt I've kept really simple. Build a tool, finds the best routes in a given city or by lateral long chords. Present nice data, pretty photos, keep it simple. Use the Apify actor, and you'll ask me for an Apify API key. This is the link to my markdown file for my actor, and make sure there's a beautiful front end using ShadCN and principles from Fast API for the back end. Let's hit enter, and we'll let Claude Code go to work on this. Okay, it's already getting straight to work, wasting no time in setting this all up for me. And boom, Best Routes Finder has loaded up. This is absolutely incredible. Okay, let's go for somewhere else like Larnaca, and we'll go for, how about cycling this time? Max distance, let's keep it at 5,000 kilometers again. We'll have any difficulty and we'll find those routes. Now it's doing so using Apify to access Komoot data, and within seconds, look at that! Here we have everything we need. Some amazing routes with photos included, distance, time to do, and also the popularity score for these routes, so I can be certain that I'm finding the very most popular routes. I think next time I'm in Larnaca, I might well cycle this route. So there you have it. Now you know you can build your own actors with Apify, and there's the $1 million actorization challenge. What will you build? Let me know in the comments down below, and remember to use the link to sign up and try this for yourself, as I'll provide you with my starting template files that will make it super easy to make your own actor within a few prompts. Thank you so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.